Now let's see what Haki does here. I hope he SDs less. But this is a very weird matchup that I have never seen. So I won't be talking very much about the matchup specifics.
Yeah, so Game & Watch is actually a very, very good character. The only thing that really messes him up is the fact that he is not very good in the air, and also the fact that his shield is basically non-existent.
Yeah, yeah, his floatiness is very struggle for every Game & Watch player, and his weight, he dies super early.
Exactly, and like he literally does not have a shield.
And a few areas he can't air cancels, but exactly. Aside from that, he's a great character.
Yeah,
with very strong moves, very quick ones as well. Throwing out a sausage before edgeguarding Haki.
His moves are really good. And like his parachute, I don't exactly know. I think it's his nair. But
yeah, it's his nair.
Right, yeah,
he has a huge hitbox.
Exactly, huge. It has a huge hitbox above him and like inside him as well.
Yeah.
You can't challenge that from like any
no.
angle.
It has a huge distort joint above because the entire parachute is his hitbox.
Yeah. I think his body actually is a hitbox as well. Because sure. Yeah. Frank, like Ryzen, usually we play some weird stuff as well, and
yeah.
He does play some Game & Watch every now and then. And I try to challenge it from below, and you can't
actually challenge it
from below.
Yeah, from above it's not possible, I'm not sure about below. He wants to start with those hammers though. Let's see if he can get at least one down throw hammer or something. That would be fun. Wow, clean sweet spot. This guy definitely knows his character. Very
absolutely.
Clean sweet spot.
Well, but to be fair, if you're playing such a low tier, you absolutely have to know
Yeah, you have to know every tool because you have to use every tool in your arsenal.
What I really like is that he has been basically not using his shield at all because
that's just the character.
He basically doesn't have one.
Yeah, unfortunate. One stock lead for Haki.
Almost everything shield stabs Game & Watch.
Yep. Oh.
Haki is playing
very
pretty
safe
good so far. Yeah.
Yeah.
Haki's actually a very safe player in general.
In general, yeah.
Yeah, in matchups he doesn't know, or in matchups which he knows that he has to play defensive, he can't really camp you out. Although he's playing Ganondorf,
yeah.
He's very good at camping.
I'm not sure what happened those last two stocks, but part-time Noob just died.
That was unfortunate, yeah.
Yeah, I know, but
I really thought, like, had he actually drifted towards the stage, he would have landed on stage, I'm pretty sure, but
yeah,
he tried to be stylish and go for the ledge, and for some reason didn't quite.
Yeah, that sometimes just doesn't work out. Counterpicking to a Pokemon Stadium, huge stage. I think that Game & Watch also has quite some good mobility.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely better than Ganon's, I believe.
Absolutely.
And controlling space is easier with Ganon. So you have to, choose a big stage. The down
yeah.
Bs are coming out again, just like versus Technic. Oh, nice fair.
And
can he edgehog him? Nope.
And Haki absolutely does know his moves, so.
Well, of course. He played a lot of characters, but he's been playing Ganondorf for a while now.
Yeah. So he is getting a lot of those hits in.
Yeah. That almost kills. Like, Game & Watch is so light.
Game & Watch
oh,
sounds
that
so funny when he's walking. That was
yeah.
a really nice fair. I
he's
can't respect
he's
that.
Always beeping through.
Beep, 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 beep.
Yeah, beeping everywhere.
Nice back air.
Yep, but DI saves him. Oh. Oh no. Did that really have so much lag when landing on stage? Oh.
Does quite look like it.
Oh no, he has a chain grab on Game & Watch as
Holy
well.
Moly.
That's, wow.
This is crazy.
But yeah.
What is this madness?
I thought,
get me out of here.
I thought so that he should be capable of doing slide DI and jump out at around 14. And I think he did that. I'm not sure if Haki just messed up. Right now we have a 3 stalemate.
I don't think
that anyone will go over there. He's just throwing sausage.
Is it sausage or is it pancakes?
I will never know. Some say it's bacon, I say it's sausage. Oh, that sausage flipped like crazy.
Yeah. I wonder if Game & Watch is actually able to do the wind around.
The what?
You know, when you're beneath the tree.
Yeah.
And you walk into the like pit thingy beneath the.
Do you fall through the stage?
No, you don't fall through the stage,
yeah.
But when you walk up against it and then you jump, you basically, as Fox, you basically wind around the whole thing and land on the platform right in the pit.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow, what was the dub smash? Fantastic, and he let it ring. Nice.
Ding, 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 ding.
He's such a fan character, unfortunately he's not a very good character in this game.
Yeah, if he had actually better, if he had the potential...
Yeah, there are things that we discussed earlier, then he might be a very good character.
If he could actually L-cancel and if he had a shield, he would definitely be a pretty good character.
Oh, just rolls in behind him and jabs him. No having stage control. Never mind, the dash attack sends him the other way. Oh, I would be careful with those double jumps in Haki's plays. No, not quite reaching. Wow, atrocious DI.
Yeah, but to be fair, Haki is really, really good at getting those aerials.
Definitely.
In.
We got this transformation coming up again, and Haki just challenges it. Should just wait down there, like, no reason to go up there at all. If he wants to deal some damage.
Where Haki is right now, if you just move forward as Fox.
But Dimedum just comes up here and edge guards him.
Nice OP.
Yeah,
you just run against the tree and then...
Damn!
Let's go.
Just gives it to him. Deed. It's like the scuba mask or something, right? The up smash. Yeah. It looks so cool.
Doot doot. Beep.
Beep. What the heck?
That happened when I played Friendlies with Dimedum as well. That looked so troll.
I hate Pokemon transformations.
Yeah. A lot of people have been calling it pretty homophobic names.
We won't call it on stream. Well, that will do it because Game & Watch is so light.
Haki takes it in a 2-0.
So light and floaty.
Respectable. I wonder if Haki can make it out of pools after losing to Technic.
I think he shaked his head there. He wasn't very happy about that. Haki Digi. But Huda that sucks. Haki. The weight of Game & Watch sucks.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate.
A few characters have the tissue, like Mewtwo. If he would be a little bit smaller and would weigh a bit more, he wouldn't die at 60 or 70 to a Fox up smash, and he would be actually a very decent character.
Yeah, his
but he just isn't. So
yeah, obviously Mewtwo's punish game on spaces is just absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah,
we've seen Leffen do it time and time again.
Yeah, but he's the only one, kinda. There is like that one Japanese.